Hello again friends, so today I'm going to look at the Redmi 8. So this is the entry device from Xiaomi, and we can see here the specifications. So this is a 32 GB ROM and 3 GB of RAM, and okay, let's do the unboxing. Let's see what we have in the box. I'll put here this, and first of all we have here this is the SIM tray ejector, and here we have the user guide with some data about the setup. This is the warranty card, and of course this is a case made of silicone. It's a transparent one, so it's okay. So this is what we get on top. Here we have the device. Okay, so this is the red version, and you can see it's pretty glossy, but the finish it's okay. We have here on the back the fingerprint, and then the two cameras. One it's 12 megapixel and the other one it's portrait. So on the bottom we have here the USB type C and the headphone jack, along with the microphone and the speaker. On the right we have the buttons, power and the volume, and here we have the SIM tray, and on top we have the microphone and the air blaster. Okay, and let's go further with the unboxing. So we have here the charger. This is a I think it's 5 volt 2 amperes. Okay, and what else do we have here? This is the USB type C cable, and it's a USB A to USB type C. Nothing else in the box. That's about it. Let's put this aside and let's look at the device. So what seems to be nice about this finish, it's the reflections. Maybe you can see it, so it has a lot of reflections. I will compare this, let's say, to the Galaxy Note 10 Lite, because you see it has similar reflections. But yeah, this is has something else, like other reflection. So yeah, you can see this they are very similar in the reflections, the light reflections. So yeah, I will kind of compare them, but of course the screen is a lot bigger on the Note, so you can see here the difference. But yeah, this is how it compares with the Note 10 Lite. Okay, let's put this aside and let's look at the device so we can pump up the brightness. So here we have the screen resolution, and it's 720p. We have accelerometer, magnetometer, a pseudo gyroscope, and the IMX486. This is a 12 megapixel camera on the back, and it does a good job. Also the processor, it's Qualcomm Snapdragon 439. This is the entry level, it's a octa-core but 12 nanometer, so it should be pretty efficient, and the power consumption should be low. What else? We have Android 9 on the device, memory 3 GB of RAM with 32 of ROM, and the camera. This is the Sony IMX486, and the battery 5000 milliamps, and the temperature range it's okay. And of course we have the sensors here. The gyroscope seems to be the one that's pseudo. I don't know what this means, but it detects some movement. Okay, and okay, what else about the device? So this is updated to the latest Android 9 and latest security, and yeah, let's do the disk speed. So we can see here the disk speed was pretty okay for an entry device. Okay, and Antutu benchmark. So 96,000. This is okay for an entry device. It will not be a GPU, let's say, beast, but it is okay for most daily tasks. Also the CPU is okay. And you can see here the temperature has rise with 2 degrees, specifications and all of that. Also I have run Geekbench 5. And let's see the result. So we have here in the history, this is a compute. And yeah, it's not the best out there. So even it's lower than Galaxy A15. Also for multi-core A112. Yeah, and also the compute, OpenCL. And you can see it's on par with Redmi Note 7. Oh, even not, it's 3 times lower. So yeah, the GPU on this device, it's not that good, but what I have found to be pretty okay, it's the camera. So we have here the stock camera, and let's say it does some pictures okay. Let's try and snap this. Poke. And I have also installed the Google Camera Go. This is the version for the Android Go devices. And let's take some picture. And also Google Camera, this is a full APK. So I will post the pictures that I have taken here. So yeah, this will process the picture and it will show up. So yeah, it has some good camera. You can see here the blur in the back. And overall the design, it's okay. The back plastic feels sturdy in the hand. And the fingerprint scanner, it's fast. And what else? Software feels fluid, even it's Android 9, but it still feels snappy. So overall the device seems to be okay. This is a very cheap device, around $100. So yeah, I can recommend this, especially if you install the Google camera, so we can see if you use that with the night camera. So we can see if we use the Google camera in the night mode, it's a lot better than the stock camera, which sees nothing almost. So yeah, I definitely recommend this to be used with the Google camera. So yeah, overall the Redmi 8, it's a pretty simple device, but it does a good job with what it has, and the camera, I will definitely recommend it with the Gcam app. So yeah, thank you for watching.